Yes, okay. I hope I will be, it will be possible for you to also hear what I'm talking. I'm trying to say in English, sorry if my English wouldn't be perfect, but maybe that would be easier. So here I thank you very much to be invited for this presentation. Here I can present only one work of my rather long career of almost 30 years, Madness of Majka Skowron, Szaleństwo Majki Skowron. It was a television serial from 1975, Polish television, which was based on the book by children, book for teenagers, Madness of Majka Skowron, Szaleństwo Majki Skowron. In 1975, this work was broadcasted in only two television programs, which was in Poland at that time. And it was probably the first such a popular film, television serial for teenagers, when the main heroine, the main person, the base of a whole story was based on the teenage girl, which was deciding about the life, deciding about what she would like to, putting some pressure on her father to change his moral decision, etc. That briefly what was this story about. And I have to say that I was this actress, teenage actress in that time, this 40 years ago. And when I started my art career, I didn't know what I can do with this heritage I'm carrying. I was thinking that it's rather very difficult and not very interesting. But then I met my colleague who was doing a found footage works. He was really a specialist, art specialist of found footage projects. And we decided to do it together. And my idea was to cut the fragments of this original television serial and then compare it with the different memory culture of culture which was I was carrying through 40 years. So I quoted lots of films, basically Zabriskie Point, The Doors, lots of documentaries, which I found in internet, but not only. And I cut it and linked with each other to make a certain visualization of a mood, of ideas, of values, which was carrying from 68 up to now. And I was showing this, here I am showing you only one episode, because the installation is constructed from the few episodes. It's a kind of exchanging the idea of television serial into the serial which can be shown in the gallery. In the gallery, I'm showing all the episodes simultaneously in a small screens or big screens together. So it is kind of cacophony or full of images at once, which comparing what was in 70s, 80s, 90s, up to today, and also some shooting which I have done with the person who is replacing the original Majka, the girl. And I asked for this, my daughter, Melanie. She plays this temporary, contemporary Majka. So it is. So this work, you can see her now walking and meeting some other hero of my video. What it very carefully, music, images, text of the music, lyrics, meaning of a certain gestures. Everything is very important for me, and found footage gave me possibility to say a lot about time passing, memory, culture loop, behavioring loop, values which are connecting generations, which are realized or not. So this particular formula is a very good and kind of easy collage, video collage, which give artists lots of possibility to express and to transform a certain meanings. But then what happened when I'm quoting Pulp Fiction or some documentaries or Hair or whatever, I forgot even what I quote that time, I have to look at this. For example, Blue Velvet, The Doors, Star Wars, Last Tango in Paris, Pulp Fiction, Star Wars again, another episode, Empire of Passion, Underground, Tokyo and Erotica, Star Wars, another episode, Matrix, Solaris, by Tarkovsky, Three Women, Dead Man by Jarmusch, Stalker by Tarkovsky, Last Highway by Lynch, Mulholland Drive by Lynch, etc., etc. I took little fragments and transformed them into my own conscious and memory. But this is not only my own, it's a generation conscious and memory. I put them together, what was created in culture, I put together with the original documentaries to make people remember or locate a certain important moment in culture in our history. I was showing this project in Venice Biennale in Romanian pavilion, in Romanian representation in 2011. And I'm showing this work in a very different places. For example, mentioned already MAM Rio, the Rio de Janeiro, Museum d'Arte Moderna, which also own my work. But I never sell this work. I'm adding this work as a donation to the museums and gallery and private collectors when they are buying some other work of mine. So, next to the acquisition, there is always donation. I don't want have any problem and any question about that I'm doing it for my commercial purpose, because I'm using all of this not for the I'm using all of this even if it is a commercial fragment, and transform them into the culture fragments, into the culture piece. So consequently to my work and idea how to work and how to use this great artist in my art, I'm not selling, I'm giving it as a present, as a gift. This is actually all I can say about this, and I can only invite everybody to the museums and the galleries to see this kind of work. And I hope that we artists, we are using at that moment in this situation in law, which is sometimes very questionable and not very clear, that I hope that we are doing well, and we are doing using the parts of the work of others. We are, as law is giving us this possibility, we are adding a certain values, we are telling that this and this particular work can have another meaning, can be understood differently, can be understood even more, and can add to the culture even more if it is shown in a different context. That would be probably the shorter thing given today, but if you have any question, I would answer, and maybe my work will talk more and clearer than I. Thank you very much.